Welcome back to the Bob and Tom Show. Editor's note.
Who's editing?
Me. This may be the day that Christy slips up.
What?
Oh, does
there
she
have been some problems.
Who's she going to curse at, you think?
I'm not sure. It could happen, though. She had an interesting traffic issue.
Oh, my God. Today has gotten off to a horrible start.
Yeah, so she's just telling you.
Already?
Be prepared. Welcome back. This would be the, or this these are, I should say, the Knapp Auto Parts Studios. Our engineer, of course, the auteur behind the Ace Cosby joke of the day. It was referring to Ace Cosby.
Yes, on tour, that's what he is. Yeah,
and
baby.
The always agreeable Chick McGee, where the scientists are trying to determine how far up the
keister.
Old keister of the bird
I'm
is
just
today.
Saying, I'm just saying that I think White Rabbit by Jefferson Airplane could be the worst, most popular song in the history of the world.
No, it's a great song. It's brilliantly arranged. The writing is tremendous. The playing is stellar.
I think it's pretty strong.
Ominous and trippy.
Of the moment, in the time when it was released, amazingly socially significant, but of course,
that's probably how they
overlook all these things.
That's probably how they brought the song. Here, it's going to sound like this. It's brilliant.
Yes, Yorma, could you make your guitar sound like it's farting?
And they did it to, and they just did the song to shut Grace up because she's a mouthy.
All these things are wrong. She's a brilliant, perfect pitch singer.
Oh.
Let's just move forward.
But then it spawned the after school special that scared me to death.
What's
what was
that?
Wasn't it called Go Ask Alice?
Yeah, the book was, and then the special. That's an important book for some people.
Feed your head.
Oh, she's bombastic. It's wonderful.
It's a great song. There's a terrific interview that I just heard with Paul Schaefer and the bass player Jack Cassidy and Yorma, the guitarist, just recently. I don't know where I heard it, but I did. It was great. And there we go.
You're not hooked immediately.
Great bass line.
No, that.
Not even.
Tremendous soldier-like military drumming.
Scared me straight, that special.
You guys have a nice time.
Psychedelic guitar. Simple yet brilliant.
Absolutely.
And then...
Noodle.
Oh, it's good, man. It's good.
It's not noodling.
I respect that you don't like it. But
no,
good.
I have no respect for you because you're an idiot. See,
they're probably aspirin.
Mom has the placebo.
Yeah.
Aspirin can be handy in the event of a heart attack. That's a great song by the Jefferson Airplane, and how dare you mock it? Everything about it is brilliant.
No. Now here's a brilliant song.
Oh.
Is this Lawrence
Luck? Yes.
That makes you bounce up and down in your chair and everything.
Yeah, to get out of the room.
Mom, I'm going to go play in the street.
Yeah, there's some cars coming. I'm going to jump in front of them.
This does sound like an evil clown theme, doesn't it?
Hey, could you make this a little whiter?
Yeah, this is...
That sounds like someone's out having some little... infusing it with a little soul.
That's the song a lunatic plays when he's making a suit out of skin with his, sitting at his sewing machine in a dank basement.
Yes. Turn on the bubble machine. Ace, did you find...
The bubbling bubble.
I gave Ace an assignment. How much is a bubble machine? Did you find out yesterday?
I'm still looking.
Okay. Jesus,
good job. Didn't thanks,
look.
Ace.
You didn't look at all.
No.
To get someone else.
I don't remember him being told to.
Yeah.
I specifically assigned Ace the job of finding me a bubble machine.
We can have a bubble machine here tomorrow.
I said I've seen them at a rock concert.
Yeah, that's all he said.
Right? I can get you a bubble machine for anywhere between $32 to $200.
$200. We want the real deal.
Yeah, we want an actual bubble. We don't want any.
Fill the room with bubbles. Yes, I know it's radio. Bubbles.
A professional wireless bubble machine is only $45.95.
Wireless. Yeah. Whoa.
Are we talking stadium filling bubble machine?
No, not that big.
Okay. I just love it when bubbles and stuff at concerts. It always makes them fun. Confetti falling from the ceilings. I love it.
Try being a janitor at one of those places.
Bubbletron.
Like
oh, really? I thought that's your
plastic.
Big issue.
Yes.
Try being the janitor. Yeah. Ask the person that washes your underwear what it's like being a...
Hey, Josh, how is it washing your underwear? Not bad.
No,
professional wireless
today?
Bubble
machine.
I am, yeah. $45.95.
That's a good deal.
Professional wireless bubble.
Now, this actually segues perfectly into sports. Once again, at the orangeinsoles.com sports desk, it's Chick McGee. Yes.
I mean, it does.
We have the story. Did you see the update about the lady that got shot by the t-shirt cannon?
Oh, no.
Magic Johnson says it's more fun making money in business than watching the Lakers keep losing. He doesn't know how the Lakers are losing. He doesn't know why that started as soon as he became president of the team. He doesn't know what happened.
He also doesn't know why people won't hug him or shake his hand or share a glass.
Wow.
Johnson has said he quits as president of basketball operations of the Los Angeles Lakers. This happened Tuesday. He called a news conference without talking to the front office or current coach Luke Walton or any of the Lakers players. Just called a news conference, says he quit. Lakers have had losing records in the last two seasons with Magic in charge. Mm. He did not tie his resignation to the future of Coach Walton, who was expected to be fired by Magic. But now, of course, one can assume that with Magic, he's not going to fire Luke. He's not in charge of the team anymore.
Right.
Something had to change, right?
That'll be left to somebody. Speaking of the NBA, Dallas Mavericks star Dirk Nowitzki has announced he is retiring from the NBA. That's right. I will never play basketball again. I'm going to return to my home life and not bother anyone or steal state secrets. Yes, just because he has a German name, I'm saying anything.
Mountain of money.
Yeah,
playing a long time.
He has, and I'm sure he has every dollar.
Why?
NFL news, DeMarcus Lawrence, that means the Marcus Lawrence, is the highest paid team from Dallas player ever.
That's a sentence.
Yeah.
I'm going to put those words in order.
Lawrence is the...
What is a Mad Lib Sports?
Defensive... Well, it's a Cowboys...
Dallas team player NFL salary dollar.
Fun with Syntax with Chick McGee.
The first NFL exhibition game, they announced the preseason yesterday, sort of. They announced your opponent, but they haven't assigned...
You know the NHL playoffs start tonight, right?
No. The first NFL exhibition game in Hawaii.
It's all football.
You got NHL games playing in Hawaii?
No.
Well, all right then.
The ice would melt.
That's right.
You think some people think that? NFL exhibition game in Hawaii in 43 years, Tom. You know how your fascination with Hawaii and your contention is that there's always been a television show in Hawaii because people like to look at Hawaii?
I think there's almost always been a major television network show that was created in Hawaii, pretty much.
That's interesting.
I think almost every year since TV's been around.
Yeah, Tom, that's interesting. Tell us more.
Well, do you
have any- I think it is. People do like to look at Hawaii. I do.
I do.
So we say aloha to the cliffs or the mountain of Mauna.
That's, of course, where they filmed Lost until they couldn't find an ending.
I thought they wrapped it up pretty well. I enjoyed it. Very emotional.
Guy carrying around his own
you
casket.
You sobbed like a baby.
Body.
I did,
right?
Yeah. They filmed Moana in Hawaii.
Moana was a cartoon.
That's right.
And I believe it took place in, wasn't it supposed to be in Tahiti?
It took place in Tahiti, but they shot it in Hawaii.
Yeah, okay, you keep thinking that.
Okay, the Blues play the Jets tonight, evidently.
Yeah, a lot of people saying Winnipeg will...
At Winnipeg. At Shea Stadium.
St. Louis Blues and Joe Namath, the New York Jets.
The New York Jets.
Don Maynard, Emerson Boozer, provided he's...
It's going to be a fascinating game.
Of course.
Emerson Boozer, of course, at the AA meeting.
What are the chances they're going to win?
You know, when they name you after...
are we going to have process. Him pick hockey games?
A ton of these playoff series are going to be... It's going to be great. They're going to be teams beating up on each other. They're going to go 6-7 games, and then the next round will be really interesting.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I'm fascinated. Can we get back to the t-shirt cannon? That's a good story.
God.
Atlanta and Denver will face off in the Hall of Fame game in Canton, Ohio on August 1st to open the preseason.
He's doing stories about games that don't count.
The preseason schedule was announced yesterday. And now the... Oh, no. Yes. The nun who threw a perfect pitch, first pitch for the Chicago White Sox, now has her own baseball card.
Cool.
Aww.
What?
Remember the big story last year?
Yeah. This is another one of his big stories.
This is a great
story. The big story about a nun who threw out the first pitch and hit the catcher's mitt like you're supposed to?
I don't remember that. She tossed the ball, bounced it off her arm, and then heaved it.
Me either.
Unbelievable.
What game was it?
It made the International Newswire.
Oh, Jesus. Here we go.
You going to read the story?
Did. We need a... Did. Every time you mention the International Newswire,
Calling all.
What?
Last August.
Cars. Attention, calling all cars and all the ships at sea.
Let's go to press. Flash. Last August, sister Mary Jo Sobieck became a viral sensation. I don't remember this.
How could you? This was
after
a weekend,
she bounced the baseball off her arm and threw a strike for the first pitch.
I have no doubts that we did the story. It's just quite, now. Quite
was she on the mound or was she way up front?
Yeah, she was. Yeah, Chrissy, she was giving the sermon on the mound. That's her favorite passage of the Bible.
Now, a baseball card featuring the nun from Marion Catholic High School in Chicago Heights will be sold in Topps trading card packs.
That's a shame.
Starting on July 17th.
What'd you get?
She's a White Sox game?
Yeah. Hey, I'll trade you the nun for stab me in the eye with your pencil.
You got Mike Trout? I'll trade you two Trouts for a nun. How about that? She's set to autograph some of her baseball cards.
She is on the mound, ladies and gentlemen.
On Monday. Yeah. Next Monday, April 5th. Sobieck said she plans to donate $1,000 Topps is paying her to a scholarship fund at her school.
Isn't that nice? Okay, Christy, by the way, I'd like to prove my point. Christy, can you see my screen?
What?
The source on this is from August 21st of last year.
Yes, I'm Christy's watching the video.
Yeah, we're watching
right
the video.
The source, metro.uk.
Right.
The International News Wire, ladies and gentlemen.
Ladies and gentlemen.
It's not the International News Wire. It's a service from the UK.
But here she is on Good Morning America.
Right.
So.
The International News Fiber might be more accurate.
They're saying a perfect strike. Would you call that a strike?
I didn't see it.
It was a high announcement.
She's kind of high.
She's a young woman.
Oh, well, it wasn't even a strike.
She's a nun, okay?
I thought she was a feisty young nun.
She is on the mound. She's not
like Sally Fields.
She can hit a
She can
hit a knuckleball with a ruler.
Yeah, that's a strike.
Okay.
Yeah. So that's cool.
Muscular
It's a nice fundraiser for the kids.
Enjoys tennis.
Oh my God.
Flannel shirts.
Hanging out with other nuns.
Now we're going with that attack. Yeah.
Woman? Right.
You know that she's terrible though in her softball league because being a nun, she refuses to steal.
Oh sure, yeah. Ever since this though.
By the way, they also came out with those John the Baptist bobbleheads.
Oh, those are nice.
The heads come right off.
Yeah, those are good.
she voiced the high hard one on the three.
Are you aware of the John the Baptist? Am I just ever cracked open a Bible?
Off. No. I heard you. Heard it all. Got the concept. Sorry. Laughed accordingly.
Although she's a great pitcher.
Oh yeah.
Being a nun, no one's ever gotten to second base with her.
Oh. Well, we don't know that. She could be getting the D on the reg.
Wow.
Before she joined.
Or another D.
I hope you guys like hell.
She may have been the slump buster that the...
the other chubby nun...
All right. All of you need to stop.
I am trying to be nice.
Nuns aren't real, right? They're just...
Nuns aren't real.
Cartoons. Stereotypes.
I thought they were just costumes.
Remember that singing nun?
Remember that singing nun, that thing?
Whoopi Goldberg?
I only go to third base with the Lord.
What?
No, I
is that how it went, Dean? Maybe that wasn't...
That sounds familiar.
Maybe those weren't the lyrics.
Dean's just shaking his head in disgust.
No.
Felt up by Jesus.
Yeah.
That's me.
No place.
The holiest time of year and not the time to be making these jokes.
It's always a good time.
Oh, yeah? It's holy right now?
Holy.
Well, yeah. Easter's coming. Not Easter.
Lenten season?
Easter.
Easter's coming up next weekend. Not this weekend, next weekend.
Oh, and I haven't even shopped yet.
Wow. So in any event, that's fun. It's a baseball card. It benefits your school, so it's a great idea.
Yeah, but she's giving them to a scholarship. We don't know what brat she's going to pick to give that to.
Oh, my God. I mean,
if we had some say as to who, could be a dummy.
Okay.
Doesn't really deserve
it. Do you know what happens if, when you were a kid, did you ever do the thing where you took a baseball card and put it in the spokes of your bike and drove
No.
Around?
Yep.
No?
No, I'm not 82.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Hey, Josh, you ever get a stick ball and play stick ball in the street?
Oh, no, we were far too busy kicking the can. That's right.
You ever swim in a fire hydrant?
You find a nice can to play with. You can play with it.
Oh, I kicked it for 4 miles once, all the way to the general store.
That's right, and then FDR told us, you know what you do.
And I said, I'm not taking kick the can advice from FDR.
No, God, no.
What the hell does he know about kicking anything?
He can't kick for...
He just goes down
down there and floats in the
ice. The day you kick polio is the day I kick a can, the way you say.
Welcome to hell, ladies and gentlemen.
This
we're
has
here.
Been a rough break. Yeah, a lot of it's been my fault.
This has really been a rough break. You're right. Rough break. Rough break.
You guys are all in trouble.
Yikes. That was very rough.
If only that were true.
You put the baseball card in the spokes, but it sounds like a motorcycle. Friend. You never did that?
No, our baseball cards were too valuable to us. We had the Beckett, like the guide, to look up how much each was worth and stuff.
Okay.
Plus, the baseball cards now, they wouldn't take it in the spokes very long, I wouldn't think.
Right, you know. Put that nun card in, it goes, bless you, bless you, bless you, bless you, bless you.
Oh, that is
kind of a holy thing. We're going to come right back. We have a lot to get to here.
You ever take it in
the spokes, Tom? That's apparently an attempt at some vulgar reference to utterly ineffective and, I believe, not funny at all. So let's just give that the...
Oh, John the Baptist bottlehead.
Oh, the John the Baptist bottlehead's ready. Look, Billy, it comes right off.
He should be holding a tray with his head on it.
Cool.
We'll be right back to the Bob and Tom Show. We were talking about cringeworthy moments with the other Jess yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
And we all have those cringeworthy moments. We're getting a lot of mail about some of those, by the way. You should probably read some of these. From the Bob and Tom app. Describe the Bob and Tom app, won't you, Jessica?
Well, it's a free app you can download at iTunes or Google Play. And while you're there, you can listen to a local station, listen to Bob and Tom 24/7. Access the Bob and Tom VIP. You can also send us messages, text messages, emails, audio messages, like if you're a junior windbag, that's how you can send us those little voicemails.
Now, by the way,
you can let us know how we're doing.
Yeah.
Well, Chick, apparently, you have a windbag out there after you.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh. After me? What did I do?
This comes to us from Mark. I'll read it as pompously as possible.
Yeah.
In other words,
no, we know.
In my regular voice. It should be pointed out that the singer of the song Johnny Angel,
yes,
which Chick played yesterday, is in fact Shelley Fabre. By identifying her as the wife on the show Coach, is the equivalent to identifying Paul McCartney as the singer from Wings. Have you not heard of the Donna Reed show?
Wow. Yeah, she was him.
Why you gotta be such a windbag?
She went, her and Paul Peterson. Paul Peterson, I think, the other kid on the Donna Reed show back in the 50s.
Yeah, Shelley gorgeous.
Maybe 60s.
Shelley's gorgeous to this day.
Hey, we should shout out to the Black Moods, by the way, since you just played.
Oh, yeah, the Black Moods.
Number 39 on the Billboard charts for their first new single that just came out.
All right.
So really great. Well.
And the Black Moods are going to be our house band again in a couple
weeks.
Coming up
in a couple weeks, mid-May. So, yeah.
Very excited about
that. Way to go, Josh and guys.
That's the other Josh.
Not me. Nope.
Not Josh
Kennedy. Not Josh Arnold, not Josh, my car guy, Josh.
Right, right.
There's only one person in the Black Moods, according to Christy. It's Josh.
It's the only one.
Go on.
An old tripod,
it's
you mean?
Kind of memorable.
Old dreamy long-haired tripod.
Josh was wearing rather tight pants. What's the old phrase? They were so tight you could tell his religion.
Yeah.
Let's look at it.
Oh, my goodness.
Hey, according to a recent study.
Wiener.
By the way, I just learned all the hookers in Hong Kong have wieners.
Yeah, apparently.
That?
I didn't know that.
I didn't know that.
I thought it was Thailand, but according to a recent study, 1 in 4 Japanese adults in their 20s and 30s are virgins.
Huh.
Researchers at the University of Tokyo found that sexual inexperience has risen in both sexes. In 2015, 23.6% of women between 18 and 39 were virgins, compared to 21.7% in 1992.
Wow.
25.8% of men were virgins in 2015, compared to 20% in 1992.
A quarter of the men are virgins.
Yes.
And
this
the
makes
rates
sense. Of adult virginity
Why?
In the UK, the United States, and Australia are between 1% and 5%.
This
just
totally
so
makes
something
sense.
To
Wait, I'm sorry. I didn't hear the.
Compare.
So 1%, between 1% and 5% of Americans in that age are virgins, but.
Yes.
But 25% of Japanese.
Why does that make sense?
Japanese men.
Because these men have grown up on Japanese porn, and they're afraid once they sleep with a woman, tentacles are going to pop out of her back. Have you ever seen Japanese porn?
No, is that what happens?
Oh, is that because it's all pixelated?
That anime stuff.
Anime stuff.
Yeah.
Oh, I haven't seen that. What does that mean? Are you serious? Is that what they do?
Yes.
I thought Japanese porn, all the delicate parts are pixelated out.
Yeah, right? Most Asian porn is,
That is just bizarre.
Yep. Yeah, I'm not into the anime, but I've seen some.
That's like a superhero thing. The anime?
Kind of. It's animation, and it's always disgusting. Weird monsters. And
I thought it was because of they all live at home and they've got those thin paper walls.
Could be.
So
they didn't want to hear.
Yeah,
they don't want to be heard.
They're very sensitive about bathroom habits. I know that.
Yeah, why didn't drywall make it over there? They're all paper walls, right?
I don't know.
I'm right on that. Sliding paper doors.
I can say something, but it's really, really horrible. It'll be my last day on the air.
Okay.
So they're not really construction workers over there. They're origami.
Yeah.
Wow. We had to fold new house. That. Okay, that's what you'll hear. That bread time.
Yeah. Okay. Well,
coming up, we still have to get to today in history.
Give us one.
On this date in 1912, the Titanic set sail.
Ah, oops.
Yeah. Well. Didn't end well.
Yeah.
See you in New York.
Don't forget to pop on that GPS for the icebergs.
I love you, Jack.
She could have pulled him up on that damn door.
Yeah, there was room on that
there
door.
Was plenty of room.
Didn't
on
they
that
do that
selfish
on Mythbusters?
Bitch.
Didn't in Mythbusters?
Yeah, they did.
Do the door.
And there was plenty of room, wasn't
plenty
there?
Plenty of room.
He would have been fine.
Okay.
Unless the guy in the bar.
Well, I haven't seen this movie yet.
Oh, okay. Oh,
Jesus.
And the guy in the beret is trying to get on the door. I
cry and cry.
Really?
Oh, yes.
When he sinks into the water?
No, not at that point. Bloop, bloop. I cry when there's a couple, like an old couple in bed and the water's rushing underneath their bed.
Oh, and they hold each other?
Yeah, that gets me. And then what gets me is when the ship is clearly going down, the architect fixes the clock.
Yeah.
And he just feels, oh, I can't take it.
I love that actor. God, I love that actor.
That's Victor Garber.
Victor Garber. Yeah.
Real name, Leonard Rosen.
Real name, born Leonard Rosen.
So was it worth the 1,500 people dying for all the guys that got to third base for the first time watching that when they were in high school?
Wow.
Maybe not, huh? Okay.
What?
We'll be right back.
Back with
this
more.
This is the Bob and Tom Show.